Hey everybody, Hayden Dingman here for PC World, and today we are going to start a new series, Steam Shovelers, and we're basically just going to go through and pick up a bunch of games from March. In case you didn't know, March is a real crazy month this year. We had, I don't know, Mass Effect, Nier. What else came out in March, Adam?
I don't know. Oh, you're putting me on the spot here. I don't know.
We had a bunch of games come out. It was crazy. So a lot of stuff fell through the gaps, and we are just going to check out some of those games and maybe give you a window onto some stuff that you didn't know that you wanted to play. So anyways, without further ado, we are going to jump into Four Last Things, which is a Renaissance-themed video game. I would compare it to maybe Monty Python in terms of the art style. He basically has I think it was only one developer. He cut out like a bunch of pieces from various Renaissance paintings and animated them and turned them into like this crazy art style. It looks really cool. So yeah, as we go through, and obviously this is, I believe the Garden of Eden that we are supposed to be in here.
I thought this is the Garden of Earthly Delights.
Is that what it is?
I think that's what it is.
Okay. And then we've got like this nice Adam and Eve, and this is, I believe, God over here, and he's telling us to not eat the fruit, obviously. And we are just gonna go eat that apple, cause.
This is a very interesting looking game.
Yeah, as I said, it's very like Monty Python animation-esque.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much the style of humor also that we get. We might reach it in this little thing. There's a point where you can touch somebody's donkey with the expected results.
Oh, goodness. I don't know if we can show that on camera.
Anyways, we're basically the setup here is that we have committed all of these sins, but we committed them in a different church's jurisdiction. And so in order to come in and confess our sins, we have to, redo all of those sins in the current jurisdiction. And then they'll allow us into the church to come and confess.
Perfect. Confessional, very important.
Yeah, very important to them.
Is he holding a head?
No. Which guy? Our guy?
Yeah.
He's holding his hat in his hand.
Oh, okay.
Like a good gentleman about to go into the church.
This little priest thing is like petting a cat. Is that what that's doing with his hand?
It looks like maybe a cat or like a weird lion, and then like a deer on the other side.
So have you beat this game?
I have. It's only like 2.5 hours.
Oh, okay.
It's actually a very short little game.
Is the writing on point the whole time?
Yes. Some of it is dumber than others, but for the most part, it is all pretty witty. The thing I like about this game is it's just much different than anything else that I've played in a long time. Like everything from like the aesthetic, like obviously it looks very different from every other game. And then like the comedic timing on it is real good. And comedy is typically a very hard thing for people to get right in video games.
Oh yeah.
I think that this one, not every joke hits, but a lot of the jokes hit. All right. So yeah, they're telling us to go sin. Somewhere over here. Yeah. Here's that donkey.
Yep. Okay.
It's the best moment in this whole game right there.
Perfect.
But yeah, so all of these people are here to confess their sins also. And each one of them stands in for a different sort of, thing. So this is the greedy businessman. We have this prideful knight. But yeah, it's just a really cool looking game. And has a really unique sense of humor. So
cool. Love it.
Yeah.
Who makes it and how much is it?
Oh boy, you're gonna put me on the spot now.
Sorry.
Are we supposed to know these things ahead of time?
Yeah, you know, it might be somebody might be interested.
It is developed by Joe Richardson, and it is an $8 game.
Oh, good old Joe.
And yeah, as I said, it's pretty short. It's like a 2.5-3 hour experience, depending on if you get stuck on a puzzle. But pretty short and easy.
Cool.
And very pretty.
Love it.
Good.
Well, yeah. What else you got?
What else do I have? I have Snake Pass, a game I've never played, but have heard is good. And since I've never played it, we have to wait for the dumb Steam setup to run. Snake Pass, it is a platformer where you can't jump. That's pretty much all I know about it. And you can't jump because you play a snake.
Would that actually be called a platformer where you can't jump?
I mean,
I think that doesn't seem like...
still have to like make it to the next platform. So,
okay.
Technically, I think yes, but
that makes sense.
The interesting thing about this game, I mean, we just recorded a video. We can't talk about it very much, but we just recorded a video for Ukulele, which is also a very 90s style art platformer.
Uh-huh.
And from what I've seen of Snake Pass, it also looks very 90s platformer-esque. It's got that same like super bright colors and dumb anthropomorphized animals. Also, unskippable cutscenes.
Oh, my favorite thing about the 90s.
Here we go. Yeah, we are a snake.
Oh, that's cool.
Not lying.
Wait, but I actually found out this weekend you're not a big fan of snakes, are you?
I am not a big fan of snakes.
So how does this make you feel? Actually being...
I'm fine with digital snakes, especially like this snake looks pretty cute. So
it is a cute snake. Well, I would say the snake that you met over the weekend was pretty
cute
too.
No, it was not a cute snake.
It was albino, you know?
Snakes are cute in real life. Oh my God, this is difficult. Yeah, so as far as I know, this is not like a Banjo-Kazooie type game. It is more of like a puzzle game that just happens to be a sort of platformer. And yeah, they're not lying, you cannot jump.
Is that supposed to be water that he's eating? Or
I don't know, or if it's just like magical fairy dust.
Okay, because he's consuming a lot of it.
But yeah, so we can lift our head and we can... Oh, man.
Huh.
And we can like wiggle back and forth, and that seems to be like the main ask here.
Nice. This is like a real snake physics, huh?
Yeah. As I said, I haven't played this before, but I'm actually really digging this first level. I don't know how it would hold up over, 12 or whatever, but this is a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's very interesting.
Very pretty.
Especially since, like you said, it's kind of closely related to Ukulele in the design.
It feels like a 90s platformer, but with like a cool twist to it.
Yeah.
Instead of like Ukulele is like a very...
Also an interesting physics mechanic that, I mean, I can't think of any other games that have that in it.
Yeah, me neither.
Where you're actually coiling.
Cool.
That's cool.
I can do like a cool coil move by like spinning around like that.
I wonder if you get like unlocks or something to... more strength or I don't know.
Yeah, or like actually like a snake and I just get snake.
Nice. Referential.
Yeah, that might be a good time to move on to next game, but yeah, I'm really liking this. I'm looking forward to playing some
who
more
makes
of
it and how much.
Oh my God. You're screwing me, man.
Sorry about that. You know, you gotta ask the
I'm gonna have to make a list.
I gotta ask the important questions here. Sorry.
This is a game by Sumo Digital. Oh no, we're never gonna get back. There we go. It's a game by Sumo Digital, and it is $20. So
all right, cool.
A bit more of an ask than the last one, but very pretty.
Yeah, promising.
Really liking this.
I like it.
Cool. Moving on.
Yeah. Well, what do you got next for us?
Another game I haven't played, I've heard good things about. It is called Cosmic Express. And let's just go ahead and look now. This is a $10 game, and it is by Cosmic Engineers and some other people that are listed here.
Okay.
It's a game about trains.
Cool.
So, and this is a puzzle game.
And it's made with Unity.
Always the best.
And great.
Yeah, as I said, I haven't played this, but I've heard good things about it. As far as I know, we are just drawing some train tracks to the next space. So looks like we picked up a passenger and then dropped them off and then left.
Not hearing much in terms of sound.
Yeah, me neither.
I might as well check the setting. Yeah, it says
we got sound.
Oh, it's there. It's
yeah,
just
it's
real
just
low.
Very quiet.
Okay. Andromeda, is this a like
this
a?
This is our new Mass Effect.
Yeah, this is the real Mass Effect Andromeda. Wait. So do you have like a limited number of tracks? Are you trying to?
Well, it looks like we only have room for one passenger at a time right now.
Okay.
So it looks like we have to like do some crazy. This is like the least efficient train of all time. but it looks like we can do that. Oh yeah.
Oh, okay. I see what's going on.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah, so like we only have the one passenger right now. So we have to make sure they get to the right place.
Man, I'm having a hard time with this one because it looks like the guys that you're picking up, if only they just, you know, kind of walked a couple steps, they would
blocks.
Be where they want to be. So that it's a little disappointing that they can't just
come
do
on.
That.
You've never taken like a San Francisco Muni car for like two blocks or something.
No, I guess not.
I don't know. I hope these orange guys actually fit in this. Ooh, they like have a little tentacle.
Oh, but they only go to their own.
Yeah, they only go to their own color. This is like sort of a race metaphor, I think. I don't know.
Oh yeah, we're crossing into some dangerous territory here. Mass Effect Andromeda, you know, really hitting hard.
Wow, this is a weird map too. Yeah, I like this. This is a cute little easy game. Seems like. Oh, maybe not so easy already.
No.
Uh-oh.
No, I think you have to go. Ooh.
I can still only pick one of them up. I gotta like do this crazy thing.
Yeah, okay, there we go. Yeah. That works.
Yeah.
There we go.
Whoever laid out these trains, first of all, invest in like a couple new cars. Second of all, this is like the worst efficiency rating I've ever seen.
Yeah.
But yeah, as I said, $10. I
wonder how many worlds there are.
I don't know. This
looks like it
looks like it goes on for a while, but it looks. I mean, I'm liking this.
It's puzzle games, you know.
Yeah, cute little puzzle game, and rapidly getting more difficult. I'm already at wit's end here.
It just makes my head hurt. No.
What if I like? Nope. I'm just going to end up in a corner. Well, that seems like a good point. good point to move on to the next game. This is Cosmic Express, a puzzle game about trains. I've heard from people I trust that this is the best puzzle game since Steven Sausage Roll last year, which was another game that I really loved. So
another game that I had not played.
Yeah, Steven Sausage Roll, if you want a real head breaker, that is the one. I think I made it through like half that game's puzzles and then I had to give up because everything got way too crazy. So maybe worth checking out. And we are going to finish up today.
Yeah, what's the last one?
Stories Untold. Which is temporarily on sale for $7.50, but is normally a $10 game.
What a deal.
By No Code. And this is actually
You have played this one?
Yeah, I have. I played this one all the way through. And what I found out is this game was actually one of the developers, or maybe more than one, worked on Alien Isolation.
Oh, okay.
Working on the like the analog tech in that game. So like the scanner and all the stuff that like had a real good, like, I don't know, look and feel to it. Like it felt like a real retro futurist type thing.
Interesting.
And so I'm going to probably jump to the second one just so you get a better idea of how the game plays. The first episode is more of like a text adventure, and you are in a room, playing a text adventure on like an actual computer that's within your computer.
Okay. Is this FMV or no? This is,
I think this part is FMV.
No, that looks generated.
Yeah, that looks generated, but it
evokes, you know, that feeling that.
Yeah. Well, and cheesy, yeah. FMV, and the actual feeling. Game is definitely not FMV.
Okay.
But yeah, it's got a real, Stranger Things vibe to it.
Ah, yes.
And you can actually play a demo of this, the House Abandoned, the first episode, which is that text adventure episode. It, they released that for free, I think maybe on Itch last year.
Okay.
So you can, if you are interested in this game, you can kind of try that out as a demo.
Opening credits as well, you know?
Yeah, as I said, it's very Stranger Things type. Yeah. But yeah, so each of these episodes is different in terms of what they're asking from you, but it all is sort of the same concept, which is there's like a blend between like this digital world that we're in and like very analog type hardware. So it's a lot of like flipping switches, and there's one where you use like a microfiche machine and like zoom through a user manual. It really leans into obviously that like 80s aesthetic.
Yeah.
And so in this one, we're doing experiments on an organism that is within the chamber over there. So we're going to run through like an X-ray and like a sine wave generator and a couple of other machines.
Nice. Is it an oscilloscope?
Yeah. So yeah, we're just getting like some basic instructions here, and then...
Are you just using your mouse to press keyboard buttons, or can you use
your
keyboard?
No, so there's no keyboard. You can use your keyboard for the text adventure and stuff. In this one, we don't actually, I don't think, use the keyboard.
Well, or maybe the E and the M for experiment and manual.
But yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this first one we have to do is the X-ray. And so we need to turn on the camera, set the monitor to X-ray, and then charge the X-ray device. So hitting tab, we move over to our other panel here. So we are going to turn on the monitor and then set it to X-ray. And you can actually, there's a lot of like tabbing back and forth in this game.
Isn't IR infrared?
I haven't switched it yet.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So I was just going to show, there's like this key down here on the bottom right. So that you can refer to what you actually need to do.
There we go.
And then we are going to turn on the camera, which is up here. It's now our awaiting X-ray data. And then this is our actual X-ray. So we are going to flip that switch, which means it's charging. And then once it's green, we click on the sync button. And then, boom, we've got our X-ray up here in the top right.
Great.
And yeah, the whole game is sort of just this. It's like using this... in very analog machinery in ways that you would use it in real life, but it has like a supernatural spin to each episode. And it's sort of like an anthology. Like the first three episodes are very separate feeling, but it all sort of comes together in the fourth one. And yeah, I don't know. This is probably one of my favorite games this year.
Wow.
It's just like a really fun... And really, like, it's fun, but also like very creative in the way that it uses this tech. As I said, like you can tell once I heard that the guy from Alien Isolation was involved in this, it all sort of made sense because there is that feel of like a lot of care being put into like things that we sort of don't really think about in real life, like the physical act of like having to press buttons to turn on hardware and stuff like that.
Could you see this playing well in VR?
Yeah, I actually wish that they had a VR version. I don't think that they do yet, but maybe at some point.
Maybe coming.
But yeah. Anyways, that story's untold. We're not going to spoil any of the supernatural craziness.
Oh, good.
It's definitely better if you're surprised by it, but
nice.
That is the basics of that. And that is our March roundup. Stories Untold, Four Last Things, Cosmic Express, Snake Pass. Four games that maybe you missed this March in between all of the AAA craziness.
Nice.
Yeah. All pretty cheap, all found on Steam. Definitely worth checking out if you're into more experimental games and not just like I want to play Mass Effect or whatever. You know Mass Effect exists. We don't need to tell you about those, but
great.
These maybe. Awesome. Thanks, Adam.
Thanks, Hayden.